once again to this beautiful Wednesday morning. The Lord is good, and His mercy endureth forever. We are learning this week on the relational dimensions of anger, and the Lord has already spoken to us the last 2 days. Let me read a scripture to you this morning to form the basis for our discussion. This is found in Proverbs chapter 19, verse 11. The Bible says, "The discretion of a man deferreth his anger. It is his glory to pass over a transgression." Listen to it again. "The discretion of a man deferreth his anger, and it is his glory to pass over a transgression." Wow. Beloved, most times you and I feel that the moment we start getting angry, you can feel it start coming on. You feel that there is no option, there's no choice, that you can just fall into it. You might as well say what it is you want to say. No, he says you have a discretion, and that you can actually defer your anger. You can choose not to be angry. Wow. God says we have that discretion. We have that power. But why is it that then when the incidence of anger starts rising up, that we lose control? Pride. Pride. You must have the last word. You must say something. But beloved, learn this morning, you have control. God has given you that authority and that ability to defer your anger. That means you start getting angry, you just stop. You just stop. You stop the conversation, you get away from the thing, and you just wait. You will see then the Holy Spirit will immediately come in and help you get a hold of yourself. And then the relationship is protected and preserved. Consider this next dimension. He says, "It is to your glory when you overlook what people have done wrong." He says, I love how the Living Bible put it. It said, "Kindness makes a man attractive." He says, he makes a man attractive. He said, "It's to your glory. It's to your glory to pass over a transgression." In other words, when you don't nitpick people about every little thing, they respect you. They honor you. Then when you speak, they want to listen because you don't pick on everything. It is to your glory to pass over a transgression. It's to your glory to defer your anger. Before I leave you this morning, there's something the Holy Spirit quickened to me as I was meditating on this word, that many of you get angry when other people prosper, when people receive what you desire from God. And you don't know that the scripture commands you to rejoice with them that do rejoice, and then weep with them that weep. You don't just weep with people, but you don't know how to rejoice. The time to remember that you have not received is not when someone else has received. No, you rejoice with them, knowing that the same God that answered them will answer you in due time. In this light, I was thinking about the prodigal son's elder brother. Now, I don't have time to read it. The Bible said that when he came home in Luke chapter 15 and heard the music and the celebration, he inquired what that was all about. They told him that your brother that was lost is returned and the father is celebrating. And the Bible said he was angry and he refused to go in. Beloved, his was physical. most of us is emotional. We will refuse to rejoice. We will refuse to commend. We will refuse to approve. We'll start nitpicking it or criticizing it or talk it down. Beloved, you will learn in this kingdom that if the Father has blessed, you rejoice with your Heavenly Father. If your Father has honored, you rejoice. As I know so many preachers who cannot rejoice when God has blessed another preacher. They run them down. I know when he was little. I know when he was nothing. These are little kids. People make all kinds of sneering comments. And then when I observe, God doesn't do anything major with them. Beloved, you need to learn that when God is rejoicing, you rejoice with God. When God is blessing, you sign on. When God is favoring, you sign on, beloved. Don't join the persimmon seed Christians, those that are always mean-spirited and ugly and miserable themselves because no prosperity is working in their life. I don't try to suggest that everything prosperous is of God, but you can tell when the Holy Spirit is blessed, when God is at hand. Beloved, learn to rejoice with them that rejoice and then weep. Defer your anger. If you feel it coming on, rebuke it. Take authority over the devil messing with you. Reject it. Be a Christian. Stand strong for God. Then he will remember you and bless you. Thank God for his word. We love you. And we'll see you tomorrow. God bless you. Bye-bye.
Welcome to the resurrection.
Welcome.
The Lord is waiting.